You're gonna have to go on without me.
No way. I'm not leaving you.
Fine. The black sun, Jodie. Or nobody will make it.
He's right. Come on, Jodie.
Finish this. Because they don't recognize you anymore! Your anger has changed you!
I miss them! I miss them so much!
I'm gonna destroy the condenser! And if you want to stop me, you're gonna have to kill me!
I missed you so much.
You're the only one who can fix this, Jodie.
Do it. Do it for me.
Jodie, fuck, there you are. What
what he was looking for. Come on.
The Black Sun. Just take this
and do it. Oh no, those things are gonna slaughter you!
Take the damn belt and destroy the fucking condenser. Get out of here before I change my mind.
Inject you with a neural acid, which will put you in a permanent coma. Exactly what we did, Mr. Matter.
It's too late, Jodie. It's too late.
Stillborn.
We couldn't leave each other. Our souls were bound together. I loved you and hated you for years. You were a part of me.
Being in love.
I love you, Jodie.
Growing old.
I love you.
So many things I still have to do.
Aiden?
We made it. Jodie, we made it.
Aiden?
Ever since the Black Sun was destroyed, my memory has been disintegrating. I spent too much time on the other side. Now it's eating away at my mind, erasing what's left of it. My memories are all confused, slowly self-destructing, fading like a dream when you wake up. I'm losing my sense of time. I no longer know what happened before or after. Everything's playing inside my head at the same time. It's like watching the same film looping over and over again. A chaos of images with no order. So I've been writing night and day for weeks, trying to put my life down on paper. If I forget everything, these pages will be my memory.
3 months after the fact, the investigation continues in an effort to determine the cause of the accident that cost 283 lives on a Pentagon military base. Government representatives confirm that the authorities are working hand in hand with the investigators to shed light on this appalling tragedy.
The CIA is leaving me alone for the moment. I suppose they're too busy building another condenser to worry about me. I know they'll never abandon their experiments, now that they know what's on the other side. Honestly, I don't give a damn. Now I need to reconstruct my life. My life without Aiden. For as long as I can remember, I dreamt of living without him. Untied, without his constant presence by my side. I got what I wanted. I've never been so unhappy in my life. I feel like part of me has been amputated. Crying all day. I know it's stupid. Shit. I miss him so much. It took months. Months of nothing passing by. When I woke up, I knew it was time. Time to start again. To build a new life. It was so obvious. Deep inside, I always knew. I just needed the silence around me to hear what I was feeling. It took me a while to realize how much I loved Ryan. I'd been alone and sad for so long. I'd forgotten what it was like to love someone. we traveled as far away as we could. I had to learn to love again. To put my trust in someone, to stop fighting and running away. In short, I had to learn to live. Ryan and I never talked about it again. As if it all never happened. As if the other side didn't exist. As if it could never come back into our lives. See things at night. Terrifying things. I tell myself it's only nightmares, but I know it's not true. Once Pandora's box is open, it can never be closed again. No. It's what is about to happen. I've died twice already. I'm not afraid of death anymore.